Very good morning. We will continue with pushdown automata. Last day we saw what is a pushdown automata and the basic working of a pushdown automata with the help of a data structure called a stack. Now we will see something called instantaneous description of a PDA, or you even call it ID of a PDA. ID, instantaneous description of a PDA. It is nothing but an informal notation of how input strings are computed and how the operations are performed so that it can either be accepted or rejected in a PDA. Now, this instantaneous description is more of, you can say it to be a graphical notation. It is a graphical notation, and this is how you normally denote. Now, before we go into PDA, we'll just revise our finite automata. You will have a state called A, you will have another state called B, and then on a particular input, you will change yourself from a state called A into a state called B. This is how you do the graphical notation of a finite automata. Now let's see, in a push down automata, how do you do the graphical description? It is almost the same. You will have a state called, let's say, A, and you will even have a new state called B, and of course, you will be having a transition from A onto B. Now, if you look in finite automata, this is how you write your input string. It's simply an A. But you know, in PDA, when you write your input string, you will use the instantaneous description, which is nothing but a tuple of size 3. I call it a triple. Now, this is how you write it. For example, you will write A. So this A is nothing but, I will say it is my current state, or you can even say it is your input symbol. It is your input symbol. It can be A, it can be B, it can be C. If you're encountering the end of a string, like, you know, let's say you have a string A, B, B, the end of the string or the middle, beginning of the string, it can either be null or epsilon. So it can be any symbol, might be an alphabet or epsilon. As I told you, it is a triple, comma, B. Now, this B is the symbol on the top of the stack. B is nothing but the symbol on the top of the stack. Let's say, okay, now my current symbol is A, or no, in this particular case, my current symbol is B. So we'll see that in detail. Anyway, B is nothing but the symbol on top of the stack. Now the third one, you write it with a slash. You put a slash, and then you write the third part of your tuple. Now, the third part of the tuple is the element which is pushed onto the stack. The element which is pushed onto the stack plus the just previous top of the stack. You see that in detail when you do an example. Something which is just pushed onto the stack, and together with that, the just previous top of the stack. Now, we need to see this in detail. Now, this can either be an element. It can either be A, or it can be, or it can be C. It can even be epsilon. Now, when you write A, B, or C, or any element, it means you are pushing things onto the stack. When you write epsilon, It means you are doing a popping. A popping is nothing but, if you have seen it earlier, you pop when you have a match. So that is your third element called C. So I'll go once again. Instantaneous description means it is a three tuple. A is your input symbol. B will be your top of the stack. And C, it will be something which is pushed onto the stack plus the just previous top of the stack. Now we'll see about that in detail with the help.